There aren't too many analyst notes out so far, but I have read some from BMO, Citi, as well as Wells Fargo, and they all seem to say this is very manageable for Johnson & Johnson. If you assume that all of the complaints are going to double by the end of the year and it's at, you know, $250,000 a piece in terms of settlement, it's a rounding error for Johnson & Johnson at the end of the day. Where do you stand?
Well, we don't own Johnson & Johnson. I'll make a couple of observations. We've lived through things like this before. I think some of the notes probably referenced Fen-Phen and Vioxx. And J&J, at least in my out of the corner of my eye, seems like a decently valued company. I'd say, though, these legal issues tend to have an overhang effect because I think we're at the beginning of this process and that there's more to come out. And then there has been a little bit of a shift. I mean, we've known about the talk issue for a while, and there have been cases. But for whatever reason, the market is acting differently based upon the story today that has in the past. It's generally shrugged off the news. So not that I put that much credence into market response, but the market is suggesting that there is something new that happened this morning. And I would expect that, given the attention surrounding this, especially with the market move, that the FDA might have some more comments about this and maybe some other regulatory action. Mm-hmm.
Do you think that this perhaps is a different sort of case than Fen-Phen and the other cases that you had mentioned, only because this concerns babies and it concerns mothers and it concerns cancer and allegedly deception for decades? Reputationally, even though talc is just a fraction of a percent of Johnson & Johnson's annual revenues, reputationally, could they suffer a much bigger hit when it comes to their other products, particularly consumer products?
Well, I think you're exactly right. I mean, again, we don't really know, but Johnson & Johnson has heretofore had a stellar reputation. So anything that diminishes that is clearly going to be value destructive. So I think at a minimum, some value has been destroyed. J&J can obviously make a comeback if they, come clean, or if it turns out that this is really not as bad as we think. But again, I think it's a process, and looking back at some of these other events, it tended to take a year or two before we really got to the bottom of things. And so from a stock perspective, I think this is going to weigh on J&J for a while.
Les, the J&J put out a statement very strong against the Reuters article, calling it one-sided, false, and inflammatory, even an absurd conspiracy theory. But like you said, if the company was aware of this in the past, for a lot of consumers, this will be the first time they're aware of it. Should they have just become more public about this information a decade, 2 decades ago, even if they knew that the risk was small, as they're saying?
Sure. I mean, again, we're at the beginning of the process. I'm sure there will be more lawsuits and more press releases. If they knew about it, they probably should have said something. That's what I would do if I were running a pharma company. And I think that transparency is always the thing. And they learned this from the Tylenol scare in the 80s. Coming right out and saying it is the best way to defend against any of this. To call it a conspiracy theory, I might not have even suggested taking that tone. Even if it truly is a conspiracy theory, they should have said that the news will validate us somewhere along the way. Mm-hmm. So, J&J is at the risk of being a little tone deaf here, but they certainly have taken a hit to credibility.
All right, Les, we're going to leave it there. Thanks so much for phoning in. We appreciate it. Les Funtleyder of E² Capital Management. It's also interesting to note that we did reach out to more than a dozen analysts who cover Johnson & Johnson. As of now, 10 said they were not available. Another 4 have not responded to our requests. And a few other shareholders also told us they couldn't come on to talk about this story.